Hi, boys and girls. We are going to finish our ABCs of God today, talking about all the different names of God. And I hope you will keep those in your mind through 2021, 22, 23, and on through the rest of your life. They can really help you when you are needing one of those certain aspects of God's character. You can use them in your prayers with God. And so I'm going to show you and read to you the last scriptures for each of these that we have to finish out our alphabet. You is God's undying love. John 3:16 says, and I'm sure many of you can quote it, if not all of you, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life." His love is undying, never ending, never stopping, forever and always love. Always remember that you are loved by God forever and always. There's nothing that you can do to make him love you more. There's nothing that you can do to make him love you less. He loves you with an undying love. The letter V is the vine. In John, as it tells you here, 15:5, Jesus told his followers, "I am the vine and you are the branches." The vine is what gives life to the branches. The vine is the source of the fruit and the leaves, and everything that the plant has comes from the vine. And we are the branches, and he is the vine. So we always want to remain attached to him. Never want to be cut off from him. We want to be like this with the vine, right? So God is the vine. Okay, W is very appropriate for this time of year, because in Isaiah, there's a passage, and it's down here at the bottom of the card. It's Isaiah 9:6. And Isaiah is talking about the coming Christ. And remember, our motion for Isaiah is like rocking a baby, because Isaiah is the messianic prophet, right? He's the prophet that talks the most about the Messiah. And the verse says, "And unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." His name is Wonderful. I don't have anything for X or Z. Couldn't really find anything to go with those two. So our last one is the Jewish word Yahweh. Now, this is the way we spell it. If it was written in Hebrew, it would just be YHWH, because they don't do vowels. But in Isaiah 12:2, I want to read that to you. It says, "See, God has come to save me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. Yahweh is my strength and my song, and he has given me victory." Yahweh is the term that describes I am. When God told Moses at the burning bush, "I am that I am," this is the term that he used. And it means he's always and forever. He is. I am everything. I am love. I am wisdom. I am grace. I am power. I am sovereign. I am faithful. I am good. I am just. I am holy. All of those qualities of God in I am that I am, Yahweh God. Okay, so that concludes our alphabet, A to Z, of the names of God. And I hope that you will, again, like I said, remember those, go over those, worship God using all his wonderful names, and that they will be a source of joy and comfort and hope to you in your future. This is going to be our last Bible class video. 2020 is ending, and we have a new year, 2021. And if you're like me, maybe not, but you're tired of looking at screens, you're tired of having to do school online, you're tired of sitting in front of computers. And so I don't want to continue to do this in 2021, but I do have a challenge for you that I want to put before you that I would like you to do. First is trust in the Lord. Psalm 37:3 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will make your paths straight, or he will direct your paths, whatever version you might be using. The wording might be a little bit different. I want you to do that. And then I also want you to remember Philippians 4:19. God will give you everything you need. It says God will supply all your needs in Christ Jesus. Following along with Mark's lesson on Sunday, this is what I would like you to do each week in the time that you used to sit and watch and participate in the Bible videos. I would like to challenge you to serve. Why are we saved? God said, Mark said yesterday. I'm sorry. And we're saved to serve. We're saved to do good. Jesus went about doing good. We talked about that verse before. So we are to be imitators of him, and we are to go about doing good. So I have a couple little tag-like things that I'm going to show you on the video here in a minute. And I'm challenging you to take the time to be with God on your own, to read his word, maybe start in one of the gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, or John. Mark is the shortest one. Luke is middle-sized. Matthew and John both can take you almost through a whole month if you read like a chapter a day. Mark will only take you through just a little over half a month because there's only 16 chapters. So if you wanted to do Mark, I guess you could read half a chapter a day. But I would like you to choose to spend time in God's word and in prayer. And then I would like you to do an act of kindness for one, and that's going to be the theme for 2021. Do something kind for one in 2021. You don't have to share it with anybody. You can just do it on your own, but if you would like to tell me about it, I would be happy to have you do that. We're not to go around doing our acts for, you know, other people to see. But you can do an act of kindness even in your own home, even with your parents, even with your siblings, with your grandparents, or with a neighbor or with a total stranger, and do it for God, because we're supposed to be going around bringing joy and hope to the world, and we really need that in 2021. So do something kind for one in 2021. And I love you all, and God bless you in the new year.